Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, allow me to begin by thanking Her Excellency Dr. Rania Al-Mashat, Minister of International Cooperation of the Arab Republic of Egypt, for inviting me to participate in this event. I fully endorse the effort of Egypt to put together in this book called Stakeholder Engagement Through Economic Diplomacy, the narrative that economic diplomacy and development cooperation must be pursued in a structured way. Excellencies, the COVID-19 pandemic has revealed the essential unity of humanity and the interdependence of nations, as well as the need to strengthen multilateral development cooperation. No country will be able to control the pandemic alone. If the majority of the population of the developing countries is not vaccinated, the virus will roam and return. All will be safe when everyone is safe. Similarly, global economic recovery will be difficult if the majority of the developing countries remain stagnant and in a state of recession. Multilateral cooperation and partnerships are therefore vital to promote global economic recovery. This is one of the major conclusions of the book. I agree with the assessment that an institutional, transparent, and inclusive country-led framework is important to facilitate constructive dialogue among all stakeholders involved in development cooperation. This has to be the UN Development Cooperation Framework's priority, to reflect such a structured approach consistent with the priorities of the recipient countries. Excellencies, the 2030 Agenda and the corresponding SDGs provide the blueprint for the future of our development and the indispensable imperative to put people at the center of development cooperation and development strategies. Development cooperation and official development assistance, ODA, must be aligned with the SDGs. The SDG mapping of ODA is an important first step towards this objective. I am happy that Egypt has taken the lead on this. My own country has also initiated the SDG investor mapping to provide a framework for the future investments in sustainable development. I am happy that this book will contribute to a successful transition to the new global and equitable economic system. I thank you.